Hey guys, this is a call where I changed, no, I didn't change the evaporator coil. I remade the connections on it, did a little bit of electric work, and now the customer has called and said she smells something. So let's see what's going on.
Noticing the smell, but I didn't know where it was coming from. And then I took him out and walked. And I have a question. This is the first time I've used this kind of thing. Is that okay, the way I've got that?
Yeah, that's
okay.
It's actually very good, yeah.
Since I just started using it, I was wondering if using that thing was what was causing the smell.
And you said it's like a sour smell.
Yeah. I looked it up online, and it said something about that in high humidity environment, sometimes it can't stay caught up, or you know, with all the condensation and everything, and then it might start souring.
Well, I'm not seeing algae growth in your drain pan, but we can still put some algae tablets in there. And I'm not seeing.
Well, that would be wonderful. If that's all it took, I would be thrilled.
Plus, I probably need to make sure it's draining.
Yes.
Outside,
yes.
Instead of under the trailer.
Yes.
So why don't we do that, and that'll be a good place to start.
Yeah, because when I was researching, it said that if
all right, this is my drain. I'll probably go in over here and just make sure everything's attached. But right now, let's go add some algae tablets.
Well, good. I'm glad to hear that.
Well, guys, a lot of times on these smell investigations, when it's a house with a crawl space or something like this, when you go under, you also need to be aware that there might be a sewage leak or something like that underneath. So we're keeping our eyes open for that too. Here we go. I've seen nothing of the sort. I don't see any moisture all the way over there or over here. There is no P-trap. Let's see if anything down here has gotten wet. That seems a little bit wet. Oh my. Is that oil from before? Certainly hope so. Before it had a terrible leak, and that was just a month ago, so I don't think that right there looks like it's glued. But it is. That's good. Let's run it and probably put a P-trap on it and check pressures real quick. Okay, I don't have any glue, so none of this is glued. My PVC glue actually turned to gel. Oh, that ain't gonna hold. That's just loose as it can be. I need to go get some PVC glue.
It's a little tighter. Look at that, that's just, that ain't gonna stay. Let me look, I don't think I have any more PVC glue. Okay, I'm checking pressures and this is what I've got. 2 degrees superheat, about 2 degrees subcooling, and it's 70 degrees out here. Maybe 72 inside, I forget what it was. It's not low on refrigerant. All right, I saw that it had dripped a little bit. That was a little bit wet. I'm not attaching that yet because I want to prime this. All right, let's put some water in it and then we'll attach it. Okay. Full of water. Next time she turns it on, this thing ought to drain spectacularly well. Seeing as how it's never been through a summer before, we get those algae tablets in there, that ought to be just fine. All right, on that one, guys, the P-trap may help. Maybe it did get some moisture down there. She said she hadn't run it in 2 days. It's difficult to offer a UV light in that situation. You would have to put it above it, and there's the risk that that the homeowner could be exposed to UV light. So maybe an ionizer or something. But fixing a P-trap, maybe something that can help. And I told her about her options. If it continues, we can clean the coil. But she was complaining a little bit of what sounds like dirty sock syndrome, but that's normally in a heat pump in the winter. But I guess it could happen now if she leaves the air conditioning off long enough for everything to dry. So I guess that's a possibility. I did not charge her for anything because last time I was out there, maybe I should have seen she had no P-trap, and she's wanting to just wait and see if this will get better. She's not totally convinced that it's not a dead animal in her duct somewhere. I didn't smell or see anything that would cause a smell, so that's one of those mysteries. Say hello, Riley. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll catch you on the next one.